You have not gotten off TikTok for 5 hours straight. Since you've been home.
It's been on 5 hours.
It has. You have not looked up from TikTok. Okay, so does this count? Can I keep this? Does this count as a mumma? Deron wants me to get rid of all my moves. I don't even have moves, first of all. Let's make that clear. Stop it. I don't even have moo-moos. But he calls like my big t-shirt gowns moo-moos. And apparently he hates them. And he wants me to get rid of them.
That's a t-shirt. That's just...
So I can keep this.
I can keep this and get my name on it. But the other ones, they're like real moo-moos that come all the way down here and stuff.
I don't have any moo-moos that come all the way down here.
Well, they are.
I have gowns. Okay. I have one that's like a flannel gown.
Honestly, I think you're too young to be wearing gowns.
Shut up. How am I too young to wear gowns? I've been wearing gowns since college. The gowns are not ugly gowns. They're like t-shirt gowns, girl.
They're like tall tees.
Yes, what's wrong with that?
Just like when tall tees went out, those went out.
I'm trying to understand, what am I supposed to wear around the house?
Around the house?
Yeah. Both, because most likely what I'm wearing around the house.
Shorts. They're not hooping shorts.
Like, not hooping shorts.
Because you try to go, your first thing you do is go in there and try to get my shorts.
So like booty shorts.
Booty shorts. Like when girls are wearing on TikTok.
So that's why you've been on TikTok for 5 hours, basically. So that's...
No. I think I was watching TikTok.
So, booty shorts and... What? You talking about the onesies? The little onesies?
You can wear that too if you want to. I'm just saying, not no... Ooh.
So this is why you want to show me. Why are you watching TikTok? You want to show me a deer. A deer getting his fangs sucked. Hey, so how do you feel about the election? We don't have your thoughts.
You're just basically picking the lesser of two evils. They both suck.
First of all, Biden doesn't suck, though. He has a triumphant story.
He's senile.
He is not senile.
He get his words. And...
First of all... That man has been through a lot. If anything, he probably has post-traumatic stress. But, no. I don't think anything is wrong with Biden.
Is that boy still on the toilet?
Stefan?
Yeah.
Well, Stefan is like the poop champ. He's been pooping for about 30 minutes now. Hey, let's watch a movie. Let's watch The Grudge. Get off TikTok.
Yeah, take a shower.
What are you doing? Come here. What do you have?
Itch.
Huh?
I have a little eat.
Let me see.
Yeah, eat, Mickey. So,
Oh, you're so smart. What word starts with E?
I said,
you're done Googling. Thanks for that. Come here, Antonio. Yes, you probably got boo-boo all on your hands. Go to the bathroom. I tell you. Go to the bathroom. Come here. E is for what? E is for what?
E.
Did you just poop? What is wrong with y'all? Why are y'all so gassy? Ew. I think I'm making me some celebratory cookies. I got a taste for cookies, so to celebrate this victory, I may make myself some cookies. And then we're gonna have a little movie night. Then I gotta wake up and go to the gym and work off the cookies. Tony, are you ready for bed? Are you sleepy? Okay, so yeah, so this is a t-shirt from like when Deron was in high school. And this is the like shirt his parents used to wear to his football games. See, it has Trotter his football number? Trotter 22? Tonya, what number is that?
22.
Oh, you're so smart. It has his football number.
22.
It sounds like, how do you want me to get rid of this? You know, I think it's kind of sexy. You know, so you can kind of see my booty a little bit in it. I don't count it as a moo-moo, right? 22. I am on my way to get my lashes done. Yes, in a pandemic, I'm on my way to get my lashes done. Because I don't know. I think it's just that, you know, since we aren't going places anymore, I'm not like getting dressed up on a regular or getting my hair done on a regular. I'm just tired of looking bummy. You know, you ever just feel that way? Like, you're just tired of looking bummy. And the statement, you look good, you feel good, is very true. So, you know, and I'm not gonna waste any makeup like the rest of the girls, just putting on makeup, just be putting on makeup and to take a picture or getting dressed up. I just wanna be cute walking around the house with some lashes on. That's it. So, I found someone. I'm not gonna take y'all in there because the studio is her house. But she has like a whole little studio set up, which is cute. So I will just show y'all afterwards. But I'm going for like the wispy look. And yeah, I just wanna look. I want to look good. I want to look good and feel pretty around the house. So that's what I'm doing. I don't know, how are y'all maintaining? How are you guys, you know, making sure y'all look good and feel good without having to actually go somewhere and get dressed up? But you don't want to just be around the house like just looking bummy, because then you start to feel bummy and it's like, ooh. And then I'd be wanting to like just shoot videos sometimes, but the work of like actually putting myself together to get in front of a camera, I just don't be feeling like doing it. So if I can just look partly ready with some eyelashes, got the brows done, don't need to go put on no makeup, maybe throw on some lip gloss, boom, then I'll be all right. So anywho, I will show y'all, I was looking for that mask. But I'll show y'all what it looks like when I get back in the car. So, later. Okay, y'all, so I realized that I did not come back to show y'all my lashes because I was in like such a hurry. It went like 30 minutes over than what I wanted it to, so, yeah, I had to hurry up and go home to get ready for some deliveries that I had that day. So, but these are my lashes. She did a really good job. I will give y'all her information in the description box below. So, yeah. Gave me like the little wispy look. Deron loves them, of course. He likes for me to look like a little South Dallas hood rat sometimes. All right, so I'm about to go to the gym. Because I still go to the gym in a pandemic, unfortunately. But I do still go to the gym. It's like a little private gym, but I think I'm about to stop though, y'all, because this little gym is like up to something. When I first started going, they had like all the sanitation bottles, so like everybody could get their own little bottle and like just carry it around the gym with them and like spray down and wipe down their area. They had like hand sanitation machines everywhere. It was mask required, like signs everywhere saying mask required, social distance. They took all of that stuff down. We are in flu season and the highest corona peak that we've ever had this year, and they took away all the hand sanitations, like areas and bottles, and they're no longer requiring masks. So I'm like, what? Now, everybody that I see when I go in the gym still wears a mask because it's like, now come on, girl. But, and I definitely still wear a mask, but I'm just like, I don't know what y'all are up to, but I don't really want to be a part of it. Like, how are y'all not having any type of restrictions during the highest peak of Corona? So it's like, what are y'all doing? Like, so I don't know. I think I may change gyms because I don't like that. So, right now I'm getting ready to make me a protein shake, y'all. I have been losing weight. Hold on. And make sure I pull this up. Okay. So I have been losing some weight finally. Last week I was 155. Today I was 147. And I do plan on doing a separate video about my weight loss and everything that I'm doing. There was one key thing, y'all. There was one key thing that contributed to me gaining that weight. And it took me a while to figure out what it was. I couldn't understand why I was gaining so much weight. I'm like, I ain't eating the best, but you know, I don't eat out every day. Like, what is it? And it just seemed like since the pandemic, I just kept gaining. And then I figured it out. So I would tell y'all that in a separate video. And then there was another thing. My diet. I've always done a low carb diet. My smallest weight was due to a low carb diet. And then I just started doing like some research about my body type. And my body type, I hold on to fat. Like, if you look back in my family, you know, we are some big women as far as, you know, we carry a little extra weight on us. My body type holds on to a lot of fat. So I am doing more so a low fat diet rather than a low carb diet, focusing on my fat intake because my body, yeah, it will hold on to fat. So it's like, girl, you don't even got to worry about what you eating. We're going to get our fat from it and we're going to hold on to it for a while. So I'm like, okay, I'm gonna watch how much fat I put in my body. So that's including like good fats. I watch how much salmon I eat throughout the week or how much peanut butter I'm putting in my protein throughout the week. When before I was doing that every day, including a fat every single day. Avocado, I love avocado. Not consuming so much of that because my body is like, girl, we got our fat, we good. So ever since I've done that, I've noticed a little bit of a change. Yeah, that's what I'm doing. So I'm gonna take y'all to the gym with me, but I'm gonna make this protein shake real quick. Still using my sea moss. This is not sponsored, but y'all, I noticed with this within the last past couple of weeks, I don't think I noticed it before, but I just been doing this and my protein shake every morning. And that's the only thing I have for breakfast before my workout. My workouts are fire. Like, I have so much energy. And I don't think it's in my mind. I think it's just the fact that since this is the first meal of the day, my body is absorbing it, you know, a lot more. And I'm able to feel the effects of this versus when I was doing the protein shake, like as a second meal with this, I couldn't really tell. But this, as my first meal, has been crazy. So it's nasty though. I ain't gonna lie to you, it's nasty. If this was sponsored, I wouldn't say it's nasty. But since it's not sponsored, I'm gonna let y'all know it's nasty. And you just put a teaspoon in it and you will taste it. But The energy that you get is great. My almond milk. I'm gonna do a cup because we got a late start. And then I'm going to put some water in it because I don't do no more than a cup. If anything, I ain't doing no more than a cup. Short people problems.
And this is my new favorite protein. It is Isojet. Someone gave Naran some one day. And he gave the pina colada one though. And when I tell y'all, that pina colada protein shake was something like I've never had. It tastes like a legit pina colada. I was like, this is heavy. Oh man, I just threw that back there. I ain't even gonna be able to reach that. Tonio ate my banana! So that Tonio ate my banana. I normally do half a banana and I put the other half in the refrigerator. But since Tonio has learned how to open the refrigerator, he goes in and he eats the other half of my banana. And I am gonna do some peanut butter in this protein shake because it is 11 o'clock. And that is very late for me to be working out. So I know my body is about to be starving. So this is going to keep me from being hungry during my workouts, adding this fat. This is natural peanut butter. So adding a fat to my protein shake before my workout will hold me over a lot longer because, ooh, what am I doing? I hate being hungry during my workout. I can't even focus.
And boom. It is so good.
Ooh. What's that? Y'all, I was bagging out. And so I had a little package just about. So yeah, I ordered some clothes from Nasty Girl. I'll show y'all that in a bit. Oh, y'all, I just remember I'm gonna have to make this workout really fast because somebody ordered something from my Poshmark yesterday. And I need to try to send it today. I like to try to send stuff from my Poshmark like the very next day from the order because it's like, why not? But I want to try to send it. And so the post office is going to close at 2. It is 11:30. So this is going to be a very quick workout. Don't know what to do. So my main focus with my workout is to try to keep my heart rate above 120 at all times. As long as you are above 120, you are burning fat. So this whole time, no matter what I'm doing, even once I get off the treadmill, I'm gonna make sure that my heart rate is above 120. Alright, so I'm gonna start my leg. I'm gonna focus on butt today. So that will be a mixture of legs exercises. This kind of reminds me of like the old vlogs. Like when I first started out, used to take out to the gym a lot. But so yeah, I'm about to start with leg press over here. And then I'm doing some bell squats. So y'all see.
Boom.
actually going to the Rickey Smiley drive-in show, but we're stopping to get some Lucy's hot chicken. It's a new little spot in Dallas. Thank you. And it's like one of them Instagram food places. It'd be looking so good. Like smack dab in the middle of West or East Dallas side. East Dallas. I don't know. Can't wait to show you on my plate. It looks so good though.
And then you decide to go with it.
That's a combo. Fried?
You didn't see the side or something?
I think the mac and cheese, the fries, and the greens are the best.
Hey, it's still moving, huh?
Alright. Do you want your drink to go with it as well?
Yeah. Get a gift and everything. What is that?
Can I get a boost?
Thanks for coming out, man. Appreciate it, man. Love your talk.
Thank you.
Coming out, you guys.
Thank you. Guess you just love the attention your truck gets, huh?
The chicks dig it.
It seems like the old men dig it more.
All right, big fool. What we got? General Parker's gonna VIP, big man.
General.
General.
Huh?
General.
Y'all should have been paying for VIP, big this big boy.
I didn't see an option for VIP.
Everything.
Go on down. Shoot, you know I sure would have got VIP. Ain't no reason to not.
Might as well.
Right. Hey, everybody commented on your truck. You in this extra truck.
I'm extra.
You are extra. And then you try to get on me for being extra.
It's supposed to be behind me, I tell you that. This, which one? And the, with the dreads?
Yeah, she got on. Yeah, with the dreads.
Alright. They dread. Look at they ready, man.
Nice. That's mac and cheese. How is it?
Thick.
It look good.
Look thick.
Look good?
Very thick. Like peanut butter. But it's good though. It's good.
Y'all, we tried to just buy some VIP because I'm like, I'm not feeling this. But they are sold out of the VIP. I didn't see no VIP option when I was buying the tickets. I'm so mad. Let me taste it.
Spicy.
Tastes like that.
Oh, he
the cheese.
Huh? Like you put a block of cheese
in there, no. So this is what I got. This is the filling lucky combo. Yours look like the real stuff.
Yeah, mine's strip stuff.
Where's the honey mustard and stuff?
Look in the bag.
There ain't nothing else in this bag. I am sure. I'm about to be real pissed. They ain't get none of this.
We're gonna have a good time tonight.
We got a good show lined up for you.
We about to kick it.
Let me see the itinerary.
Okay, here we go.
Yes, man. We got a fabulous show
lined up tonight.
We're going to
get these jokes in.
You stretch. You're going to drink it back. Did you drink your drink?
To Joe Bob to come in and give us these shots.
It's too hot. It's a medium hot.
Blow your horn, just.
Well, it's already like Nashville hot.
Y'all give it up for DJ Smooth in the house.
What?
To the fellas, run this
my lips. Is that hot? Look how red it is. Mine is mild. I'm like just picking
up
whatever I can get.
I don't know how this shit gonna go down in history.
Eat your bread.
They got the same stuff on it.
Do it.
Especially if you ain't got the money to do it right.
Whatever.
You got the fake ass hair weave, the motherfucker dropping out as soon as you leave the goddamn beauty parlor. You
need
that?
All of that. I like my hair weaves.
The motherfucking cheap ass hair, we know the nature of fucking hair.
Even though I just took my nails off.
What the fuck you talking about?
It's a nice way to do a date, you know?
God make you look
looking at
you don't need the extra
all
dress.
The stuff you couldn't finish doing, you ain't got to worry about anybody.
You the right dress. You know, one of them be up here, the other one down there, this one working, the other one ain't. We don't need all that. Unless you're a stripper or you doing something, you're going to be beautiful regardless. And I'm going to tell you, I'm for real. Because you go over there.
Something's failed.
These masks the best thing that ever happened to ugly strippers. Ugly strippers got a whole
took my nails off.
Lease on life with these masks, because it's easy to look good from here up. Nigga, if you from here up and you still ain't making no money, oh, hell
I don't
no.
think y'all are going to get a chance to see this
stripping
outfit.
Is not the job for you.
It.
You need to quit. If your
it.
Ass ugly from here up.
Y'all won't see
it. Your eyebrows ugly. Your eyebrows.
Deron didn't get a chance to enjoy his food
because
it was too
up.
Spicy.
Can't nobody see that back too, missing.
Some say he's still hungry. So, may have to go to Fuel
I'm
City.
I'm telling you, dude, the strippers love after. The COVID.
Are you still hungry?
If your ass hungry. Ugly from here up.
Oh, you probably need some snacks.
You only gotta
you
be cute
got
from your eyebrows
snacks.
To the bottom of your eyes.
You should just fill the car up with snacks.
To succeed in the strip club. In the era of COVID. If you can't do that, go get you a regular job. Go work your ass
so like,
for 30
guys, it's kind of weird because, you know, you don't have the energy of the crowd, like hearing them laugh. And I can tell, like, the comedians are kind of feeling that vibe of, like, dang, this is weird because we can't hear nobody laugh. So,
COVID done changed, boy. Them doctor business is different.
For the audience, it's like,
woo,
you know,
shit, those are results. You'd be nervous.
You kind of need that energy of
glad
hearing
to get
people laugh
say,
when you're at
hey,
a comedy
man,
show.
Test is negative, but,
I mean, when
yeah,
it's funny, it's
time,
funny.
Like,
you still laugh, but it's just
that,
still,
dog.
Like, kind of awkward
man,
to, like, hear the silence
man.
Around
woo,
you.
Shit, I thought I had that thing,
nevertheless,
but.
Still just something to do
still
in COVID because it's a pandemic.
You got your good 20, 30 years to run around with that. They got pills and all that shit.
Just making the
most of it. COVID, you don't know what's going on. COVID, you, this
get
is crazy to me.
This is date
you
night.
You don't know whether, look, if you positive, you might have 3 days left.
Date
or
night.
You might be all right. What kind of shit is this? I don't let my.
Everybody got alcohol in their bottles.
You ain't quarantining in this house.
And what are we drinking?
If you come home with a positive
juice.
Test, I hope you love nature because your ass going to be sleeping in the tent out back. I promise you.
Lemonade.
I'm not coming up here with that shit.
We don't poison ourselves with the devil's nectar.
I don't care
who it is. And anybody else in their car lit.
Anyway,
we gotta get home.
If y'all
had
to get
home.
No, we gotta
here.
Get home. That's why we're not drinking.
To here. If she kiss you real hard and keep her eyes open, she got that bite. If she take off her tennis shoes and her footies is just a kind of dirty.
What?
Her
my footies be dirty?
He
should have. But he said that mean I got that bite.
If she keep her wash rags. Hanging up on the shower rod.
No,
if her
you
ceiling
do that
fan
mess.
Blades is real dusty. If her thighs scrub together when she walk and she knocked me the air pigeon toe, that's some good
somebody
good right
dang.
Now. I'm telling you, if I'm lying, if I'm telling the truth, flash your lights. If she unlock her car door by sticking the key in it and night ain't got no remote. I'm telling you, she still unlock her car with a key, especially if she got it like a BMW model or something. She got that hot.
Downtown Dallas had traffic lights. Where did he find a traffic light to hit?
He managed to knock the only one down.
The only traffic light that he knocked it down. Yeah, that's funny. Baby, I hope he's okay. God bless whoever that was.
Can't park in nobody driveway.
Family outing. Wait till y'all see our outfits. We're matching. This is not on accident. It's just we're all in tune. You are the one who bought this senseless truck. You.
It's not senseless.
Very.
Senseless.
Whatever. So we're going to a birthday party. Yes, in a pandemic. Just hoping that it is very few kids here.
I'm having
a kid birthday party. One of Daron's co-workers, his little boy is turning one. So, I mean, what are the precautions for this?
What do you mean?
I mean, like, why? The boys have their mask. I have all my hand sanitizer. Elbows. It's about to rain, too.
It looks like it's about to rain.
What? We just said it's about to rain. You talking about we're going to have to walk?
Yeah, we just going to have to walk.
Walk from where?
From here.
See? So why would you buy something that's such an inconvenience?
It's not an inconvenience.
You can't even park in traditional parking spots. Bugging today, y'all, with J's on my feet. This would be a good time for that song to, you know, resurface. Make it back to number one, since I finally have J's now.
What's up?
We're dropping off the boys to Gigi. Yep. And then we'll probably go on a sushi date. My matching outfit. See? And we're matching. We're such a family.
There you go, Danny.
Hey, Daddy got him on a tilapia.
He said, I want that broccoli and chicken like that. I'm on dad's side.
All I have for us here today. And just couldn't thank you guys enough. Thank you guys so much.
All love.
All love. All love.
Eating a cupcake.
Do it for the gram.
All right, y'all. So I am on my way to see my surgeon to possibly do a revision on my tummy tuck. Yes, in a pandemic, but it's much needed. I got some stuff that need to be fixed, like on my sides. So he's gonna look at that and see if I possibly need a revision. So, let me get my hands sanitized. With the quickness on this, touching elevator buttons. See, I still have like these things called dog ears that hang from my incision. Not so much on this side, but it kind of gives me like this love handle effect from the surgery. And it's like from that scar, so they consider that an revision. And so we're gonna see if we can get that part cut off. It's almost, it reminds me of like one of those like tags that be on your neck or something like that. So yeah, I don't know when, but probably try to get that hacked off.
A 14-day incubation period, meaning a person could have it, test negative, and still pass it to others.
And it's better to-
because the virus has a 14-day incubation period. meaning a person could have it, test negative, and still pass it to others.
Okay, so this is some tea, making me some chamomile tea. No, I'm not sick. Just being proactive with some ginger. Do you need some ginger chamomile tea? But yeah, I want some chamomile tea so I can kind of settle down. Had a busy day with shooting some content and kind of amped up. But this is some ginger. I usually let the ginger root, I always end up letting it spoil on me if I don't use it. So I just bought some ground ginger. Works just as well. Works just fine. Put some honey in here. And about to settle in. Because I ain't gonna lie, y'all. We've been out here. Y'all see on this vlog that we have been out and about. So, that's it. We're going to stay in the house until Thanksgiving. And y'all won't be seeing me out no more. I'm going to stay in. Alright? Should just put me some honey. A little bit of lemon. But, like I said, I'm not sick, just, you know, being proactive. Matter of fact, I may make him some anyway. Mr. Tough Guy. I always want to say ain't nothing wrong with him. But yeah. So yeah, we're gonna be in. I'm gonna try to get this vlog uploaded before Thanksgiving. Y'all go get tested. They saying that people getting tested before Thanksgiving is a false insurance policy, but I was gonna do it. I think it's pretty smart, you know. Get tested and then don't go nowhere. So you good. Anywho, so y'all be safe this Thanksgiving. Stay in the house if you can, please. And I will chit chat with y'all later.